I am 18 years old. I'm from Managua, Nicaragua. Well, I started English because in my country it's very important, and that I like the English. It's a good language.
And how many years have you been studying English?
Less than 1 year.
Oh, wow. Well, yes. We're here in Seoul, South Korea at a seminar put on by the State Department for English teachers from across East Asia and the Pacific. And with me is Ben. Ben, why don't you introduce yourself?
Okay, I'm Ben. I'm from China. I'm an English teacher. And I'm very glad that you mentioned that you love English. Why do you love English?
Because all my family is from the Atlantic Coast, and they also speak the English, but now that I live in the Pacific Ocean, they don't speak English, only Spanish, and that is why I would like to speak the English as well. Yeah.
Do you find that, how has it been learning English? Do you feel it's been easy for you or difficult?
Well, to speak, I think that it's very easy for me. But to write it is more difficult. Yes.
Well, Ben, do you have any thoughts about the speaking? He says comes easy. The writing not so easy.
Yeah, of course. Speaking is always the easiest part. But don't worry, baby steps.
Yeah.
One step at a time. Today your English is good. So. Don't worry about that.
Okay,
work on that, and you will learn how to write better.
Do you read a lot? Do you read a lot in English?
Sometimes when I have some time, yeah.
That's really important. Is you will just by reading English high quality English texts. If you have if you can go online on the internet and find. Books or newspapers, high quality reading materials, you will start absorbing the way English writing, good English writing, how it's written. And I think that's a piece of advice that English teachers often give.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what do you think in terms of to improve his writing, work on reading?
Yes, work on reading, maybe a piece of news, maybe short novels, maybe some other stuff. Sometimes when you read like novels, it relates to your life. It's interesting, and it will trigger you to read more.
So, for example, if you Google something called the Gutenberg Project, Gutenberg, I believe project, you can find a list of like over 40,000 free eBooks that you might be able to read on your phone or on a computer. There are a lot of free ebooks. Often these are older books that are no longer under copyright.
But classic.
The classics, exactly. Classic books. And as Ben said, if the topic interests you, if it's about something important in your own life, you're going to want to read it and absorb, the writing.
Mm. Before you know it, you've already learned. You've already
That's
finished
right.
the book.
That's
yeah.
right. Before you know it, you've finished the book. So
And also, I want to mention State of Department. They have a special website full of books,
That's right.
also with audio. So it's an audio book.
There you go. Actually, okay, so that what Ben's talking about is a website called, the address is americanenglish.state.gov. So americanenglish.state.gov. And then our website, the Voice of America, VOA Learning English website, also we have texts and audio, MP3s, all...
And video.
And video, of course, on our YouTube channel. The address is learningenglish.voanews.com.
My name is Zay Ahmed Bakr. It's from Egypt, and my wife is from the United States. And after 2 months, I was coming in the United States, but I am not that English good. My English is not good.
And tell us a little bit more about yourself.
Yes, I am studying in technological visuals in Egypt, and then Finnish, and I want to learn myself more English. Because I want to be good in English, because I tell you before, after 1 month or 2 months, I will be in the United States, and not anybody talk Arabic anymore. Everybody talk beside me is Spanish, Spanish and English, and I am not English good, because it's a tip, and I say, I want to do something, I say, I can me do something, but this is not right, this is wrong. In the right, can I make this? I have too much stuff, it's wrong in my mouth, I can't say.
How are you studying English?
Andrés have a 5 year, Andrés is boy, I have a 5 year, but this is in Egypt, it's teaching you is English for England, UK, it's not English, USF.
Well, so now, Ben, you're mm-hmm. English teacher, do you have any advice about, he says he has problems with his mm-hmm. mouth, you mean
yeah,
your
accent.
Pronunciation
yeah.
and uh-huh. accent, what, any advice?
Yeah, sure, for me, I think, your attitude matters. You know, you are working. You are calling for to practice your English. This is, you know, really good. And you are right now. We have so many technology stuff like internet. So don't worry about British accent or American accent. You can always talk to America, right? Talk to them.
Yeah.
So
do you use Skype much? Do you talk to friends or people do
yes, of course. And every day I talk with my wife. My wife now is she come back in the United States because she is pregnant mm-hmm. and most situation in Egypt is not safe. And I said she come back after me finish my paper, I come later. And most every day I talk with she on internet. Before I call you now, I just finish with she and she go to sleep. Because now it's like 11 o'clock in the United States now.